for the local time is just approaching 20 minutes past 8.
Good evening and welcome to Adelaide. I just flew in with Qantas from Sydney. Usually I don't stay at hotels in Adelaide, but this time I am. So let me show you the hotel that I picked for this trip. Hello, good evening. The place that I'm reviewing tonight is Frewville Motel Inn. Frewville is a suburb in Adelaide, located 3 kilometers southeast of the CBD. The motel is located on Glen Osmond Road. This busy highway connects Adelaide City with Adelaide Hills, carrying half of Adelaide's freight traffic. The reasons that I picked this motel are because of its clean rooms, super affordable price, especially during the weekend, and its good location.
Yes, this one. This one.
Yep. The motel is family run. It doesn't have a 24-hour reception. Check-in opens from 12 noon to 9 p.m. Check out at 10 a.m. If you arrive after 9 p.m., the owner will send you a message regarding how to get the room key. Being a motel, parking is free and no reservation is needed.
Room 11.
Yep.
4 nights. That's your key. That's your Wifi and the code of backup.
Yep. Thank you.
Did you catch a taxi or did you drive?
Drive.
Just grab a park where you can find it.
Okay.
There are a range of room types at this motel. There's Economy Twin, Standard Queen, Deluxe Twin, Deluxe King, Queen Studio and Family Suite. The major differences between these rooms are the size and the bed type. My room for tonight is the Deluxe Queen room, located at the rear of the motel, away from the main road. There's a table and 2 chairs shared between 2 rooms. The size of the deluxe queen room is 25 square meters. The bed is 151 to 180 centimeters wide. On one side of the bedside table, there's a power plug, USB plugs, and a lamp. On the other side, there's nothing. I'm sure there will be a fight on who's sleeping on the side with power plugs when there are 2 people staying in this room. On the bench, there's a general information card about the motel, a remote to control the air conditioner, and a remote for the TV. I'm not sure if you can see in the video, but both remotes are a bit yucky. There are stains on each button. I wonder if these remotes were ever cleaned. The cable TV offers a few channels. The resolution of the screen is a bit low.
This isn't steady. Everything's right up there. Just look at those. Probably shuffled a little bit.
At the end of the room, there's a mini bar with wine glasses, bowls, plates, and teacups. Checking the cup and the wine glass, I can see that they've been thoroughly washed. Next to the minibar is a wardrobe. On the top shelf, there's 1 extra pillow, a blanket, and a holy Bible. Below, there's a toaster, electric kettle, dishwashing liquid. Well, there's no dishwasher in the room, so I suppose the liquid is for you to wash cutlery in the sink. There's also a microwave, iron facility, and a hairdryer. All the standard facilities that you can find in a 3-star hotel. There's also a fridge hidden below the minibar, and I found a used box of milk. I was gonna say the room was really clean, but the milk just ruined it. It's probably a simple mistake. The person who cleaned this room forgot to check the fridge. Now the bathroom, it's actually quite big. The motel provides shampoo, conditioner, soap, and different towels. In terms of the shower, I'll talk about it when I shower in the morning. Complimentary or unlimited Wi-Fi is offered throughout the motel. A quick speed test shows that both the download and upload speed are fast enough to watch HD videos or upload videos on Instagram. Anyway, it's getting late. That's my basic coverage of the room and its facilities. I'll talk to you more about my stay the next morning. Good morning. My girlfriend actually stayed with me last night. One major problem we found with this room is the curtains. They do not block the light so well. Even at nighttime, the street light still can come through the curtains. I'm a deep sleeper, so I don't find it bothersome, but my girlfriend is pretty sensitive to lights, so she had to use an eye mask to help her fall asleep. To solve this issue, we tried to make the curtains stick to the wall a bit more, but it's impossible to keep the room completely dark. In terms of the noise level, because our room is located at the rear of the motel, the passing cars and trucks on the main road didn't bother us much. The windows here are not soundproofing windows. When there were people walking past, I could clearly hear their conversations. But during my four-night stay, I was never woken up by the noise. When there weren't any cars or people walking past, the decibel level in the room was around 33. Now let's talk about the shower. It has two problems. The first one is that it doesn't have a shower curtain, so the water can very easily spill outside the shower and make the bathroom floor wet. The water pressure is okay, it's not big, but it's also not too small. The second problem is the water temperature. It is very unstable. The water could suddenly go freezing cold or burning hot. During my 10-minute shower, there were three times that the water went suddenly cold and once that went suddenly hot. Each time, it lasted between 3 to 10 seconds, then the temperature would go back to normal until it happens again.
Can I help you, sir?
You can still use the shower, just don't be surprised when the water goes cold or hot on you. The motel doesn't have a gym, but it has a laundry room located next to room 14. Laundry powder is provided free of charge. Each wash is $4 and each dry is also $4. Alternatively, you can find both indoor and outdoor clotheslines to hang your clothes up. There's also an outdoor gas barbecue area. You can collect a barbecue bucket from the reception for free. Let's have a look at what's around this motel. The location is really excellent. The bus stop to the city is located across the road. And look at this, a 24-hour McDonald's. It's 140 meters or a 2-minute walk from my room. Today is Saturday. The bus to the city comes every half hourly from 7:01 a.m. till 11:02 p.m. and there are hourly night service until 3 a.m. On Sundays, the first service is at 8:07 a.m, the last at 11:06 p.m. and on weekdays, the bus comes every 15 to 20 minutes from 6:02 a.m. to 11:04 p.m. and the ride to the city takes only 14 minutes. Now that we've discovered a Macca's and a bus stop on the southern side of the motel, let's walk towards north. The Akaba village is 270 meters or a 3-minute walk from the motel. There's a cafe, a Woolworths supermarket, a news agency, a post office and a pharmacy. Across the road is a huge Foodland supermarket and Nordburger, a famous Adelaide-born burger chain that has really nice chicken burgers. In front of the Foodland is another bus stop. This is where you get off if you come from the city. At this stop, there are regular buses that go to Handorf and Mount Barker. Finally, the price of the motel. For a one-night stay, it costs around $79 for standard queen room, $86 for deluxe, $100 for queen studio, and so on. The price is very affordable. I stayed here from Friday night to Tuesday morning. For a total of 4 nights, I paid $328. This is an amazing rate, especially for the weekend. You can find a hotel for around $95 in the city, but that doesn't usually include parking. The room was serviced every day. When we came back in the afternoon, the bed was made, towels were hung up, and rubbish was emptied. In summary, the room was very clean in general. The sheet and pillowcases were spotless, however, some minor improvements are needed. For example, please clean the remote control and don't forget to check the fridge. The good things about the motel are its location, the modern clean room, and the good price. The two major downsides are the inconsistent shower temperature and the light that comes through the curtains. The noise was not an issue for both me and my girlfriend. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find it helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. In mid-June, I'll be staying at Hotel Indigo in Adelaide City. If you are looking for a more luxury, comfortable stay in Adelaide, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for my next hotel review.